Hello everyone, I'm Olga. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Here is the final lesson of the series English with Dirty Dancing. Today is lesson 7. These are the lessons which I've done for you so that you can not only learn English, but you can practice it, because these are not just video lectures, these are the lessons where you get to practice English. So if you haven't seen the previous lessons, I encourage you to have a look at the whole playlist I've done English with Dirty Dancing, because we get to train our listening skills, practice our understanding of the words and catching the lines, understanding the dialogues, so that you can by these lessons train your English, bring it to a new level, and enjoy watching your favorite movies in English without missing the lines, the meanings, and understanding everything, so that you can enjoy watching your favorite films. And in today's lesson, we will go through the final scene from the movie when Johnny comes back in order to perform a dance with Baby. And in this scene, he will make this little small speech. I think this is a very nice example of how to find the words so that you can show how you admire someone, how you appreciate what they've done or what they do. I think this scene is really helpful and useful for us. So before we start watching this scene, please pause this video and find the link in the description down below to download your practice file for this lesson. Now we will be watching the first part of the scene, and then we will work with practice file. So, here we go.
Who's that for thee?
Pregnant. You and me, Tina, we've seen it all, huh? Baba and Zeta serving the first pasteurized milk to the boarders. Through the war years when we didn't have any meat, through the depression when we didn't have anything.
Lots of changes, though, Max. Lots of changes.
It's not the changes so much this time, Tito. It's that it all seems to be ending. You think kids want to come with their parents to take foxtrot lessons? Trips to Europe, that's what the kids want. 22 countries in 3 days. Feels like it's all slipping away.
You know, this small part is actually very remarkable. It's incredibly important for the whole movie, because in these several sentences, they kind of summarized what was the actual story put into this movie. This is not only the story about Baby and Johnny. This is the story about all the people in this film, in this picture, because it is a great summary of the slow decay of the region that had begun during the time when Dirty Dancing was set in 1963 and had nearly finished by the time the movie premiered in the late 80s. So this is the movie about this remarkable period of the decline of this family summer vacations, which were extremely popular among Americans, American Jews in 40s, 50s, 60s, and it started slowing down and completely disappeared in approximately 80s, when children wanted to go to Europe Europe, exactly as and this character Max says, children don't want to have vacation with their parents, they want to go to Europe. So it was really, really noticeable, and there were so many resorts which actually closed. They were flourishing, they were so popular, there would be so many families coming to these resorts, but then they had to close, like slowly, one by one, they would be closing down because that stopped being popular, you know, time changes. Kellermans was modeled partially on Brown's, one of many enormous hotel complexes in the Barge Belt, which flourished from 1920s to the 1970s. The article says, I really encourage you to have a look at this article because it is extremely interesting. There are so many details. You can find the link to this article in the description down below. And the article says Brown's decline, so one of those resorts' decline began in the late 1960s, and by the 1980s most of the area's largest hotels had closed, and in 2012 the abandoned Brown's burned to the ground, a fulfillment of the fictional prophecy of Max Kellerman. And you know, on YouTube you can find several videos. People would go to the actual location where Dirty Dancing was filmed, and there is no more resort, almost nothing is left, and there is even no more lake because it dried out. There is no more lake, so it's just, this movie is already history. So the very first lines, this Tito Suarez, he says, hey Lensman, Lensman meaning hey big guy. So also I was searching for it and I found the information that they actually say two lines in the Yiddish language. And here is what you can see in your file. I included it exactly as I found it in the article, and you can find the actual resource in the description down below. So you can see that he is asking him, how is it going in translation? And Mr. Kellerman says, don't ask. And then he goes like, you and me, Tito, we've seen it all. Yeah. And Babe and Zaida serving the first pasteurized milk to the border. So this Babe and Zaida, according to the resources which I found, these are also Yiddish words, which mean grandfather and grandmother serving first pasteurized milk to the borders. So the whole line is talking about this actual business that he he's had, because he probably inherited this resort hotel from his parents and his parents from their parents, so this is long-term family business. And he refers to the fact that this business has been running for so long time that grandparents, they were also the owners of this hotel, and they would be serving the first pasteurized milk to the boarders. Boarders, these are people who stay in the hotel or some particular area, you know, like in Great Britain they have a lot of boarding schools. So such schools where children, boys and girls, or they may be separated, they live and study at the same school. That's why the school is called boarding school, because children live there. So boarders are people who stay in particular place, in hotel. So in this context, meaning clients, okay? So look, such a small line and you already learn so much. So serving the first pasteurized milk to the first boarders, meaning that it was so a long time ago. Throughout the war years when we didn't have any meat, again referring to 1920s, 40s, right? Throughout the depression, so 1930s when we didn't have anything. Lots of changes, though, Max Tito says. And then Max is saying exactly that children want trips to Europe, and this is the moment when he feels that all this business is coming to the end. And he says, it feels like it's all slipping away. You know, when you slip on something, you walk and then it becomes slippery so that you can fall down. There might be a banana skin or the road might be icy. So you slip and you fall down. So slipping kind of moves very fast and you cannot even catch it. It just slips away and it goes away. It's just disappearing. That what he is saying. Now we will move on to the second part of this scene, the one I promised to you, where Johnny comes back and delivers this small speech of admiring baby's personality. But before we move on, I would like to ask you to please give a like to this video, because it makes a huge difference to this video and my channel. More and more people will be able to find it. It will spread to more people. It will mean a lot to me. Thank you. So now just watch the second part of this scene with subtitles, and then I will tell you what to do next.
Sorry about the disruption, folks. But I always do the last dance of the season. But this year, somebody told me not to. So I'm gonna do my kind of dancing with a great partner, who's not only a terrific dancer, but somebody who's taught me that there are people willing to stand up for other people no matter what it costs them. Somebody who's taught me about the kind of person I want to be. Miss Frances Housman.
Sit down, Jake.
Lovely. I guess these lines are really simple ones, but in order to train our listening skills, I would ask you, in your practice file, just pause this video, in your practice file you have the task to read these lines again and try to recall what Johnny was saying, the words which are missing. Please try to fill them in. And as you are done, watch the scene again in order to check yourself. For this moment, I will tell you thank you so much for staying with me till this moment, watching this lesson, participating in all the lessons. I hope that you've done them all. If you haven't, please be welcome and encouraged to complete the lessons, because I believe that you will get a lot of benefit from them. Let me know in the comments below how it was, how much you enjoyed it, how many words you learned, overall your impression of this series, and if you would like me to do another series on some particular film. Please let me know in the comments below which of the movies you would like to see on my channel. All suggestions are welcome. I hope to see you in my next videos. If you're not subscribed yet, I invite you to subscribe, of course, and recommend this channel to anyone for whom it will be useful. So I hope to see you again soon. Please take care. See you. Bye.
The time of my life. No, I never felt this way before.
Never felt
yes,
this
I swear.
Way.